Hi guys, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we will learn how to find a rectangle in a binary matrix with corners as 1. Let's understand the question. Given a binary matrix, we need to find any rectangle or square in a given matrix whose 4 corners are equal to 1. For example, in this input matrix, if you see clearly, this is the required rectangle with 1s at the 4 corners. And thus, we print this out in the output. But how do we approach this problem? Let's come to a brute force algorithm for this problem. What we do in this method is to first find a 1 at any index and then try every possible combination of a rectangle to get 1s at the corners. This is a pseudocode. We iterate through the rows and columns first, and if we find a 1, we look for rectangles with all corners as 1 after the index of the present one. Since there are 4 nested for loops, 2 each for the rows and columns, the time complexity is of order m squared times n squared. Let's look at an efficient algorithm to solve this problem. What we do here basically is to look for 2 ones in a line and store this in a hash set. If we find 2 more ones again in a line, we get the required rectangle. The complexity for this code is now m squared times n. Let's now come to the implementation code in C++. IsRectangle is our main function which takes a 2D vector as input, which is basically the input matrix. This is the way to find the number of rows and columns. If there are no rows, we just return false. For the rows, the size of the matrix is the number. For the columns, the length of a row is the number of columns. Now we make a map mapping from an integer value to a set with integer type values. Now again, iterating over the rows and columns first. Then we iterate k from j plus 1 to the number of columns. Now if we find 2 ones in a column, we check if this has been found before, which is when we return true and we are done. So the if statement just checks if the column point j and k and j is a 1. Lastly, we add the points to the map and hash set code for the record. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. I hope I was able to explain this problem. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thank you.